you please tell us a little bit of background about your store and what your service is?
We sell salted cheese. Originally, my grandfather started this company in 1935. Should I be talking to you or you? He started it during the Great Depression. So in 1935, he started the store as a cut rate store. So basically what my grandfather sold is anything he could get his hands on. Pots, pans, dishes, toys, anything. So when I first came here when I was a little kid, back in the 70s, there was still some of that here, but we were transitioning to more of a sewing machine store. So basically my father, who worked for Singer when he was 16 years old, started bringing sewing machines into this business in the 60s, around the time I was born. And then it just transitioned from there. That's basically what our business right now is, commercial sewing.
Okay. How has the neighborhood changed since you've been here?
Well, since I've been here, it was very dangerous when I was a child. So I remember my father used to have carry a gun in his back pocket. That's how dangerous it was. And there was a lot of shoplifting. So back then we had smaller items, which was easier for people to just come in, run in, you know, run out. There was a lot of shoplifting, a lot of problems. My dad actually had some citizens awards because he would go around with one of the police officers. His name is Bill Giaconetti. He's very famous police officer. And he actually named the street around Taylor. So my dad used to chase criminals with him and stuff in his car because he was a foot cop. So they'd get in his car. So my dad got a couple awards for that. So it was really dangerous back in the 60s, 70s, 80s. And then the 90s it started changing.
Mm-hmm. What kind of, like, how does your store compare to the other new and up-and-coming stores? Like, does it affect your store at all, you know?
You know, our store's changed a lot. So basically, our business is mostly around the country now. So basically, probably 80%, 90% of my business is around the country. And probably 10% sales-wise, maybe 20%. We still do all our repairs here, so 100% of our repairs, or 95%, come from people that still live here. They don't live in the neighborhood anymore because the neighborhood has gotten so expensive for people to live. Our customers that used to live here have had to move out because, you know, we're talking about $1 million homes now, much more than $1 million homes compared to, you know, the 80s, they were $20,000.
Okay. Be there when you wait.
Yeah. You know I like to keep my cheeks dry today. So stay with me and I'll have it made. I'll have it made. I'll have it made. Oh, no, no, no. You know I'm really gonna have it made.
Shit,
it's a lonely view. With the bird, shit, it's a lonely. call them sweet wit. Call it fall, I'll make it to the moon if I have to crawl in. With the birds and shares, it's lonely.
Before the 60s?
Before the 60s, it was mostly Polish, Russian, you know.
Oh, so more of the immigrants and stuff.
Yeah, more of the immigrants. The Russians still live in the area. They do. On Chicago and Damon, in that area, but they shopped there. But it was mostly Puerto Rican and blacks. Mm. Yeah, it was very dangerous.
That's crazy. But now it's not as dangerous at all.
No, but at night you gotta be very careful.
Yeah.
You know, in the city, anywhere you go, you gotta be very careful.
Uh-huh. Really. Yeah, they had some high profile people, not other people, but two girls were walking, and one of them was from Ireland. And she got hit over the head with a baseball bat.
Uh-huh.
And she's still in, I think she's still in recovery, and there was like, bunch of the bars around here did stuff for her to try and get money for her, but she's never going to be the same after that.
Oh,
and that's still, you know, to this day, I mean, it's going to happen anywhere in Chicago, but still, like you said, even at night, this place is still not the greatest, you know, but that's in the city, even on, you know, Rush
Street
or wherever.
Sure, you went to New Church.
So did I.